सुन रहे हैं समाचार एजेंसी ऑफ इंडिया का ऑडियो बुलेटिन।
यू आर लिसनिंग द नेशनल लेवल ऑडियो बुलेटिन ऑफ द समाचार एजेंसी ऑफ इंडिया ऑन 8 जुलाई 2020। The country has increased the number of COVID-19 by the 7,42,417 and recovered cases are 4,56,831. Now the state-wise scenario, the Maharashtra is still increasing the number 2,17,121 and recover cases are 1,18,558. In Tamil Nadu, total COVID cases 1,18,594 and recover cases are 71,116. In Delhi, 1,28,031 and recover cases are 74,217. In Gujarat, 37,550 recover cases are 26,720. In Uttar Pradesh, total COVID cases are 29,968. Recover cases are 19,627. In Telangana, 27,612 are total COVID cases and recover cases are 16,287. In West Bengal, 23,837 total COVID cases, recovered cases are 15,719. In Rajasthan, total COVID cases are 21,404, recovered cases are 16,575. In Andhra Pradesh, total COVID cases are 21,197, recovered cases are 9,745. In Haryana, total COVID cases are 17,999. And recover cases are 13,645. In Madhya Pradesh, total COVID cases are 15,627 and recover cases are 11,768. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has said the construction of strategic road bridges and tunnel in the border area will be expedited. Mr. Singh said the Border Roads Organization BRO is working vigorously toward this goal. The ministry reviewed the ongoing infrastructure project of the BRO at a high-level meeting in New Delhi yesterday. During the meeting, the state of forward the connectivity of to border area was reviewed and the constant need for the boosting ongoing project and the expedite and the construction of the strategic roads, bridges and tunnels in the broader area was discussed. India and the US has reaffirmed their commitment to the work toward the ensuring the free, open, inclusive, peaceful and the prosperous Indo-Pacific. They also agreed on the need to deepen cooperation in the United Nations, especially during the India's membership of the United National Security Council. Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Singhal and then U.S. Under the Secretary of the State for the Political Affairs David Haley exchanged view on the number of the regional and the global issue of the shared interests during the virtual foreign and office consultation between the two countries yesterday. Mr. Singhal and Mr. Haley discussed the way to further enhance the mutual beneficial trade and the people-to-people ties, including through the facilitation for the student and the professional. His source said that the issue of F1 visa student attained online only the classes in the US was the rise during the meeting. They said the US side took the note and they said they will be keep best interest of the student in mind and try to mitigate impact. Source also said that the details, the implementation guidelines also yet to come out. India Air Force is on high long on the line of the actual control in the eastern Ladakh region. High altitude and the difficult terrains of the north frontiers of the Himalayas need the special skill and the aircraft to meet the challenge. Indian Air Force with the new acquisitions is more confident in the region. India has one of the lowest COVID-19 cases per million in the world. Union Health Ministry said according to the World Health Organization situation report, India's cases per million population is around 505, while the global average is over the 1,453. Chile has witnessed around the 15,459 cases of the COVID-19 per million population, while the US over the 8,500, Brazil over the 7,419, and the Spain is the witness over the 5,358 cases per million population. The WHO situation report also showed that India has one of the lowest death per million population. Indian case of the death per million population is around 14, while the global average is more than the 4 times at a 68. During the last 24 hours, a total 15,515 COVID-19 patients have been cured, taking the cumulative figure of the recovered cases to the more over the 4,39,000. As a date, there are the over 1,80,000 recovered cases more than the active COVID cases. The recovery rate among the COVID-19 patient has increased 61.13%. Presently, there are all over the 2,59,000 active cases and all over under medical supervision. The ministry said more than the 2 lakh tests are being conducted per day. During the last 24 hours, more than the 2,41,000 samples have been tested. With this, the national-wide sample tested for the COVID-19 reached for the over 1.2 crore. Infosys chairman Nandan Nilekani has said that the Indian stand to the benefit from the current global situation, and as a more country look for the alternative to China. He said the COVID-19 crisis will be create a new opportunity is the Indian's IT services industry as a client look at the consolidations and reduce the number of the suppliers. Mr. Nandan was speaking at a company's internal platform. Delhi government has decided to provide the free ration to public distribution system card holder till the November 2020. Delhi government said the distribution of the fruit and grains for the July the scheduled to the start in the phased manner from the today. It said that the government will be continue to provide the food grain free of cost to the national food security beneficiaries in the Delhi to the mitigate the economic hardship caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. Now will be the providing PDS ration to the NFS beneficiaries for the next 5 months from the July to November, free of cost in Delhi. More than 17.54 lakhs householder get ration under the public distribution system covered by the National Food Security. In Gujarat, the total cases of the COVID-19 has reached up to the 37,636 with the 778 new cases reported during the last 24 hours. 17 patients have lost their lives, taking the total death due to the COVID-19 in the state 1,979. Central Board Secretary Education CBSC has rationalized the syllabus up to the 30% for the classes 9 to 12 to make up the academic loss for the 2020-21 session during the COVID-19 lockdown. In a series of the tweet, the Human Resources Development Minister Ramesh Pokhariyal said that considering the importance of the learning achievement, it has been decided to the rationalize the syllabus and retaining the core concepts. He said the looking at the extraordinary situation prevailing in the country and the world, CBSE was advised to revise the curriculum and reduce the course load for the student of the class 2 to 12. In Professor Anil D. Shraddhabuddhe, Chairman of All India Counseling for the Technical Education, said online education has very, very useful during the pandemic and it will be continued to the play a significant role when the education institution start functioning normally. He also stressed the imparting the skill as a part and of education to improve the employability, which can be achieved through the various technology tools. Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman held review meeting with the CMDS of 23rd Central Public Sector Enterprises yesterday to boost the expenditure in the economics. His secretaries of the Ministry of the Petroleum and Natural Gas, Power, Gold and the Mines, Atomic Energy, he also attended the meeting. In 2019 and then 2020, the capital expenditure CAPEX by the 23 CPSE is stood 1,66,029 crore against the target of 1,64,822 crore rupees, which is a 101%. Mrs. Sitharaman said the CPSES have been the very important role in giving the push the growth of the economy. The World Bank will provide $400 million to enhance the support of rejuvenating the Ganga. Finance Minister said the bank and the government has signed a loan agreement in this regard. The second National Ganga River Basin project will be help the steam pollution on in the iconic river and the strengthen and the management of the river basin, which is home to more than 500 million people. The $400 million operation comprises loan for $381 million and proposed guarantee up to the $19 million. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adinath has asked the official to take the necessary steps to minimize the casualty and damage due to the lightning in the rainy season. This included the timely release of sand and this publishing them through the various mediums so that the people can take the necessary precautions. The mantra of self-reliant India is now showing its effect. Even the village of the Madhya Pradesh farmers have started making the equipment at a local level to reduce the cost of farming. You are listening the national level audio bulletin of Samachar Agency of India from Preeti Bhosle. On 8 July 2020, we will be take again this bulletin on 9 July 2020. If you like this bulletin, then you must be like it, subscribe and share it. We will be present again. Till then, goodbye.